Dutch or something. Early on at West Brom, and as soon as I talk of a move to Tottenham come out, he's striker. He's very unlucky of injuries. If you get a fit Andy Carroll, then that's Chelsea who proved it in the window. You know, they won't sign him apparently. If you got a fit Andy Carroll, then you've got a good chance of scoring goals. Marcus Suttner, the, was it Austrian? Austrian defender for Brighton and Hove Albion. Can't say too much about Suttner, I'm afraid. Dwight Gale, this lad, scored twice yesterday against Bournemouth. Yeah, not bad for Newcastle. I mean, a draw away at Bournemouth, a draw at home to Man United in the last two games, not too bad. Amrabat at Watford, isn't there now, he's on loan somewhere else, Olympiacos or somewhere, I think. But they, Watford beat Everton at home yesterday. Crap result for Everton, good result for Watford. Charlie Taylor, the ex Leeds United left back, had signed by Bolt there by Burnley. Ben Davies, Tottenham, very good in the last couple of seasons of when they know a player's got due to leave. Chance a player could leave, they're bringing another player for the majority of this that season. So last season they had a feeling war could be going at the end of the season, so Pochettino brought in Trippier for the majority of last season, and obviously Danny Rose has been injured for a long time for Tottenham. He's still trying to find his fitness. If he does find it, there's a good chance Man United could sign him in the summer, possibly. So they're making, you know, Ben Davies has already proved that we don't need, Tottenham don't need to go and sign another left back really. Gary Cahill, Chelsea against Man United today. Tough match for both teams. Man United have slipped from second place with Liverpool winning yesterday. Alex Iwobi, strange one with Iwobi. Got himself a bit of bother after the game against Nottingham Forest. I think he was out the night before when they lost earlier in the season in the Cup to Forest. And everyone thought he'd be punished, but he's just included even more. Strange decision by Wenger. Roberto Firmino scored again yesterday, I think. You know, he doesn't look like a natural scorer, but he does get goals for Liverpool. Morgan Schneiderlin, unlucky really. Moved from Southampton to United, from United to Everton. And just never really hit the ground running at Everton. Manja Matic, Conte has said in the build-up to today's game against Chelsea that he regrets letting Matic join Man United. That's understandable. Romelu Lukaku, another player who deeply involved with these two, even this summer when he joined Man United and Chelsea were after him. Jordan Ayew, score, you see, for Swansea. I don't know who got their goal actually. Need to check that out. Wes Morgan, big Leicester centre back. One of the main reasons, along with as well as Jamie Vardy and Riyad Mahrez and Kasper Schmeichel and Kante, but one of the five main reasons why Leicester won the league a couple of years ago. Joe Hart, the now second choice goalkeeper at West Ham. I mean, how things change for a player so quickly, from Man City's number one keeper and England's number one keeper to Torino on loan, to West Ham on loan, to now being second choice at West Ham. Probably lost his England place as well. Chris Brunt, Northern Irish midfielder. I don't know if he's a captain of Northern Ireland. West Brom player. Should be embarrassed because they are pretty much down now. Andrew Sermon at Bournemouth, signed from Norwich, I think it was a couple of years ago. Ashley Barnes, who sorry, scored yesterday against Southampton for Burnley. I think it was always in the other bloke. The other striker is really underrated. I can't remember his name now. There's two at Burnley though, there's Ashley Barnes. And there's another bloke who scores quite a few. But I think it's Barnes who scored yesterday. Jack Cole, was responsible for the goal that Leicester conceded yesterday to Stoke. I think he played a bad pass. Or was it Schmeichel? I can't remember now. I'm sure it was indeed he played a bad pass. Christian Eriksen, easily good enough to play for Barcelona, Real Madrid, any top team in Europe, without doubt. Greg Dawson scored for West Brom yesterday in that loss to Huddersfield. And I wonder, should be embarrassed. Huddersfield badge again, beat West Brom yesterday. Yesterday. Not great result really for Bournemouth that at home. Jamie Vardy, star player. Didn't do great deal you see. I watched most of that game. Joe Allen was obviously also involved in that match. Went a couple of bad tackles. Matt Ritchie doing alright at Newcastle. Let's say 2-0 draw with Bournemouth. Tamari Gray, who seems to have gone off the boil a little bit at Leicester. Claude Puel picked him a lot early on, but since then, doesn't seem to be in favour too much. He played yesterday, but not doing great. And the Dele Alli 100 club card. I think I might need this one, to be fair. We have a Pogba and we have a few others, but we didn't have a Dele Alli. Now we move on to the limited edition. Defensive cards. rough idea of how likely is that we'll need any of these cards. Okay, so this here is the cards we've just opened. Yeah, that's what we just opened. I'm going to show you my doubles now. Hey. good start. We needed two so far. In the 100 cards, we have David De Gea, Gary Cahill, Kyle Walker, Hazard, Mane, Sanchez, Dele Alli. That's all those we have so far. Thank you. today. Pep Guardiola said he'll be fit for the game. Me personally, I'd go with Sergio Aguero. Arsenal a bit struggling for strikers, aren't they? Because Lacazette is injured. Welbeck's off form. Wrestling, check that out.